Hello my friends, and how y'all doing today? This is More Truth here, and welcome to another video. Once again, we're gonna be checking out 5 more episodes from Holo No Graffiti. I know that on a previous batch, a viewer clarified that the 5 weeks of debuts from the 4th generation of Hololive was actually their 3D debuts. Pretty cool that after the 3D debuts, they were featured in the Holo No Graffiti. Let's go ahead and continue on with these episodes. So without further ado, let's actually go ahead and get right into it. I'm getting like creepy vibes over here. Like, oh my gosh. Yeah, the overtime shift though. Yeah, of course she's still working. The horror movies? Not a good time. She's working, you know. A horror staple, yeah. Definitely having a doppelganger, you know. There's a ghost? There's a toy sword and a carnival? Oh dear. Yeah, she's really concentrated on her work. Watching a documentary about penguins in Antarctica? I mean, that makes more sense. Oh no! The carrot! Oh no. What's going on with the TV? Yeah, time to go grab some snacks, alright? An Eevee? What? Catch with a peko ball? Someone's peko over there. It looks like Tokino Sora. Yeah, why is Tokino Sora right here? Oh, I'm waiting for 8chan to finish up the work. Of course. Yeah, Sora Senpai is here. Apparently, she's almost done with her work. Yeah, come watch a movie with us, Sora Senpai. Yeah, won't be scared. We have everybody together, you know. Yeah, go work, A-chan. You work pretty hard. Wait, who switched the TV though? Okay, this is getting a little creepy right here. Too bad we didn't get her. Whoa, now it stopped. Yeah, summer isn't complete without scary stories, right? Yeah, there was like some pretty creepy vibes over here, man. Like, sheesh. And yeah, I believe I had a viewer who wanted me to check out a specific comment from this specific episode. Yeah, this one from TR, right? Yeah, it was this comment right here. Oh my gosh, that was such an in-depth analysis of this entire episode. I didn't even think of any of these, man. I didn't even like figure out who was like the doppelganger or whatnot. I thought they were just like their regular selves, but yeah, thank you for that in-depth analysis. And with that said, let's go ahead and get into the next one. Oh yeah, the ship in a bottle. Oh no, Picoro, why did you do that? And now she's tied up. Yeah, ship in a bottle. That's pretty fitting, right? You definitely need a lot of focus. You gotta take lots of concentration for that. Yeah, Suisa and Coco, I already know what they're up to now. Yeah, Coco-chan's hair growing by 1 centimeter? Oh man. Like, they're trying hard to bug her, you know? Roger! What is Suisa doing? Oh, hide and seek? Come on. You're off, Suisa-chan. Oh, she hit her head. Oh man. Oh no! Coco-chan's gonna sneeze! Oh no! Ew, that was gross! Oh no! Oh no! Oh no! Hello for Bookie! What happened? What the heck just happened right there? Yeah, that ship and the ball technically looks complete right there, but I don't get the- wait, what is this part right here? Oh, okay, I get it now. Bakura, Suisei, and Coco, they're inside the bottle. Okay, that makes sense. That now it makes sense what that is. I was like confused because that was like a quick transition right there. Yeah, ship in a bottle, more like, oh shit. Yeah, I forgot I commented on that video. But yeah, like Suisei, Coco, and Bakura, they really tried hard to bug Marine, you know? And Fubuki was just like collateral. I'm kidding. But yeah, anyways, let's go ahead and go into the next one. Somen party, let's go. Yeah, Corona and Okaya will do the eating part, of course, right? Go, Shrimpy! You just throw him out the window? What the heck is happening? Yeah, Shrimpy 10 wins! Shrimpy, you did your best! Now you're dropping him back to the sea. Don't play with the food? Yeah, Shrimpy. Aw, oh, the heart, that was cute. Somen! Wait, what is the shark doing there? You forgot the noodles? Oh, there's Hachima right there. Hachima! Oh dear. 10,000 yen? Daylight robbery. Yeah, you're telling me. Yeah, they didn't really bring the money, you know? Oh dear. 5,000 yen will do. Still too much. 2,000. 1,000. 500 yen. 100 yen? What? Oh. Avoid buying stuff from resellers and scalpers at exorbitant rates. Be smart with your finances. That was one forced analogy? Oh man. Yeah, and another summer memory was made. Yeah, Hachima, you know, trying to sell the Somen, but then pretty much got ripped off. Wait, what was that one part again? Wait, give me one second. Yeah, Nagashi Somen equipment, bow in hand, empty cooler, people in need. Obviously, a Nagashi Somen party. Yeah, I was wondering what that was, but yeah, that was pretty funny right there, man. Like, don't forget the noodles, folks. You need the noodles. And yeah, it was like a nice forced analogy that Coco was trying to make right here about trying to buy from resellers and whatnot. Yeah, that was well played. Like, that was quite the plot twist right there. But yeah, without further ado, let's go ahead and go into the next one. Oh no, I remember this one. It's like Rusha opens the door trying to figure out what's going on in there. Yeah, she goes through hell every time like she goes into the office, you know? Yeah, the showdown between Subaru and Luna. Okay. Yeah, have a perfectly calm and peaceful day. Oh no. Stuck away seeing food. Oh dear. Yeah, she knew something was coming. Yeah, why aren't you opening the door? Yeah, you're on your own, Watame. Go, Subaru! Fight! There's more dark matter? Oh dear. Yeah, don't make that face, Watame. Yeah, sounds like a pain trying to stop him, you know. Wait, Luna, do you like Rusha? Stereotypical school conversation? Oh dear. Oh no, there's Luna! Just kidding. I love you because you'll eat this dark matter with me? Oh no. Not the dark matter. Black sesame seaweed hamburg steak? Oh no. What the heck were you cooking there, Hachima? What the heck, man? It may look awful, but it tastes surprisingly... Eh? I don't even know, man. Yeah, that was pretty interesting. Like, it's always chaos that happens in the office, you know? But yeah, Risha is pretty cute. Like, she just sounds so innocent in this episode, man. Oh my gosh. Then we have, like, the other members trying to eat, like, dark matter or something. Yeah, all these, like... different transitions of like what the members were doing in the span of like a minute or so. But yeah, don't cook dark matter, don't eat that stuff, Otherwise, you're in a whole lot of pain, Peko. But yeah, anyways, let's go ahead and go to the next one.
最近ぼーっとする日が続くんです。夏バテかな。ちゃんとご飯食べて。
Yeah, I wonder what's going on in this episode.
結構偏ったもの食べてる気が。
ダメだよ、しっかり栄養ある。
Yeah, gotta have a balanced diet, you know?
肝に銘じます。
それよりノエルちゃん、なんか大きくない？
器。Yeah, hasn't the world gotten bigger? Oh dear. Your surface area, you could have been supersized. Oh yeah, we see giant Noel right here. Oh no. Yeah, Mel looks tiny in comparison. Huge Noel? Oh dear. Living in the corner of the office, oh no. Yeah, don't be pessimistic. Yeah, Roboco must spend absolutely eternity brainstorming ideas. 3 minutes later. Go to hospital? Yeah, hospitals are indeed scary, man. Yeah, giant Noel, I don't even know how to get through that situation, man. Yeah, how do you even go outside? What? Yeah, hospitals are scary, man. Yeah, the hospital didn't help at all. Wait, you're back to normal size? What? I'm going home because my head hurts. Oh man, it's such a fun time in a fun place. Yeah, Noel is definitely supersized, man. Quite interesting, but it does make sense, right? It's like, yeah, Noel's like, help me, I'm big. And then, yeah, you need to go to the hospital, but you can't get out of the office. I'm like, I guess make yourself smaller then. But yeah, pretty much Mel and Roboco, man, they're pretty much struggling with this whole situation right here. Yeah, I guess 3 minutes of brainstorming is pretty much an eternity, you know? Mel was definitely relatable. My head was kind of hurting in here because I had like no clue what was happening, but yeah. Supersized Noel, look at that. Yeah, look at this end screen right here. Yep, that's pretty much Noel in a nutshell. Yep. There you folks have it right here for 5 more episodes of Holo Graffiti. Yeah, the first episode we checked out in the batch, there was literally an in-depth analysis of that entire episode. Dang, I had like no idea they were all like doppelgangers the entire time, you know? But other than that, there was like food involved in the other episodes. Yeah, don't eat dark matter, that's literally Pain Peko, man. Like lots of stuff that happens in the office, I wouldn't entirely say is normal, but it is indeed the norm of what happens with the Hololive members. And yeah, that's pretty much my overall thoughts on these episodes. Feel free to drop your thoughts below. Look forward to checking out 5 more episodes next time, so stay tuned. If you enjoyed this reaction, feel free to leave it a like, subscribe for more if you have not already, and turn on the notification bell so you can stay notified on my future content. And with that said, there's more truths, you take care. You have a great rest of your day or evening, and let the morals be with you.